back, everyone. Showing us how to make a twintastico Italian stromboli dish is the Alberti twins. Please welcome John and Tony Alberti. Welcome, fellas. So you are Italian via Manchester, England.
Yes. Yeah, our family come from Tuscany, near Lucca, you know, and was brought up with, you know, the Italian family. So, yeah, but yeah. We was born in England, hence the accent.
Hence the Northern accent, yeah. Well, being Italian, it's in our blood to cook, so we do that very well as romancing the women, which would be as well. So, yeah, it's all about, for us, it's all about family and food, cooking together, eating together at the table.
And comedy.
Yeah.
I have to tell you, I'm not sure I'm understanding every word, maybe every third word, but it doesn't matter because whatever you're saying, I believe it. I love it.
You can just look at it, don't worry.
When the two of you were little, you were identical. You were, they could not tell you apart. Let's see, look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
How cute are we?
I'm with a blue balloon, John, and I'm with
the red. Is that why they give you different balloons?
Yeah, yeah. I think so. Just have name tags.
Oh, my gosh. Growing up, did you try to, like, switch things out at school?
And yeah, we had a lot of fun with the teachers and more fun with the girls growing up, you know. Flirting's in our blood, you know, and that was, we do it very well. I even flirt with myself sometimes.
Well, they're flirting with your food. You guys get into this delicious...
We prefer flirting with the ladies. Yeah.
Get into your delicious stromboli. Right. And we're going to make it. So what is... So people at home may not know, what exactly is a stromboli?
It's a bit like a rolled-up pizza. It's really fun and easy to make and get the kids involved, you know, cooking at home with the family. Yeah. You can put whatever ingredients you want in, really, and that's a fun thing part.
Yeah, you can make it vegetarian. You can put different types of cheeses, different types of meat. But always use Italian meat. It's the best.
Okay, always Italian meat. All right, so it starts with the dough.
Yes.
But then we have to add your special sauce. That really makes it delicious. So what's in the Alberti special sauce?
The Alberti special sauce, we're going to go in with garlic.
Mm-hmm. Okay, start with garlic and Italian olive oil.
Olive oil, always.
Garlic.
Yeah.
Oh, you want to put... Let that dance in there until it's golden.
Yeah.
Mary Murphy knows all about dancing. Can you dance like garlic, Mary?
We're going to waltz afterwards, don't worry.
Yes, I can.
Then you want to add the tomato passata.
Yeah. Tomato what?
Passata.
Tomato passata.
It's sieved tomatoes. You can use chopped tomatoes if you want.
Tomato sauce in this country.
Tomato paste. And then you've got your basil and your
chopped basil and chopped sage.
Basil.
Basil.
The sage gives it that earthy, warming flavour and adds depth to the sauce. It just takes it to the next level.
Yeah. So is and this... that's a special ingredient in there.
Yes.
The sage is the
special ingredient. Is us making it. That's what
isn't that sweet? Yeah. Some salt and pepper.
Cook that off for 45 minutes, so it reduces and thickens, and then you're good to go with it.
And that's the dipping sauce that they all have.
Yeah. And that's what we all say. The key to Italian food is simplicity. You know, it's a very simple and quick sauce to make, but it tastes amazing.
Yeah, because the truth is, the simpler the dish, the more difficult it is to make.
Exactly, yeah.
Because you can't hide behind any of the
ingredients speak for themselves.
That's right. Sure. All right, I'll let the two of you speak for yourselves. Okay. So what do we do next with our beautiful
Okay. So the dough's ready. So just a tip. So when you're actually kneading dough, you don't want to knead it for about 5 minutes until it's silky smooth. And when I'm kneading the dough, I always imagine I'm massaging a beautiful Greek woman called Debbie.
Oh my gosh, I'm blushing.
Okay.
All right, Alberti twins.
You want to put the tomato passata on top. And you want to rub it all over, really.
Just like that.
Yeah. Just like on the sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you want to be generous with that?
A little bit. You don't want it too much.
Because you don't want to squeeze out the sides.
Exactly. So you can help putting the Italian meats on.
Okay.
So first off, before that, we'll just put the garlic on.
Oh, more garlic.
Yeah.
Fresh garlic.
We love garlic.
I love it. Garlic's great.
And then you want to put sprinkle on Parmigiano Reggiano all over the top. More the better.
Right.
And then it's the Italian meat time. So you can give us a hand with that, Debbie.
Okay, so mortadella.
Yeah, so we've got mortadella, we've got salami, and then we've got the prosciutto.
Just anyway, like this?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Just like that,
so
I did a good job.
So then put it all over. Then good job.
Thank you.
So, Tony.
And then the salami.
Oh, you both looked. So, Tony. And you both look at me at the same time.
We answer to each other.
That's right. You guys have a YouTube, show called Italian Cooking at Home with the Alberti twins.
Yes.
Very popular.
How did you learn to cook?
We just grew up cooking just from our nonna and watching her from an early age. You know, we come from that type of family where everyone's cooking together, and that's where we learned. That's where our passion was born. Really.
Is that your nonna?
It is in the middle,
in the middle, And that's our mum that's sat in our lap. Yeah.
And look at your grandfather. Wow.
That's where we got our good looks from.
Yeah. He was dapper.
Italian genius. But we've all been passionate about cooking, passionate about, because we all cook food and fashion go hand in hand. So we like to look good, cook good. We like to take the girls out. Well, man, serve exactly how we do it. That's
and
what we do.
Italian food is most romantic in the world.
I could never get away with that. If I said those kind of things, I wouldn't get that far.
Italian food is the most romantic in the world. We did next, but then Italian food.
Yeah, it is. It's like the food of love, and that's what we want to, you know, promote and
get
out
there. It's true, and you were conveying a lot of love. So we put the basil inside?
Basil inside, just whip that up.
We all say like the most important ingredient in the kitchen is love. You've got to be passionate about it.
If you're not passionate and you don't love what you're doing, it's not going to taste good.
Well, you definitely love what you're doing, and you have a cookbook coming out soon. Don't it's called Twintastico.
Twintastico, of course. It's going to be coming out next spring, so it's going to be taking you through a traditional Italian meal from start to finish, basically.
Yeah, and we like to be creative and inventive in the kitchen. We like to play around with it and do it Italian style.
Oh, lovely.
And there's lots of pictures of us in there.
Yeah, more pictures.
So, as long as the pictures, so you roll that way.
Yeah, so we roll this way, and then you're going to tuck it under.
Do you dance?
Got a fan, me.
Yeah, we dance.
Do you guys dance as well?
Yeah, we could waltz and salsa.
Mary.
We're going to dance afterwards.
We dance the girls right into the bedroom.
Oh, my goodness. John, this is a family show. Okay, now what?
So we're going to tuck it under, seal all the edges.
Some olive oil?
Yeah. If you want to rub the olive oil over the top.
Okay, just like that. And then we have to transfer this over there.
Yes.
Don't we? How are we going to transfer?
Very careful.
Yeah. I'm a little worried. Is that going to work?
This is going to be tricky.
Me too.
You need a couple of hands to handle this.
Always the case.
Okay, that's all right. We got it. We got it. Now a little bit of salt.
So much. Okay,
there we go.
A bit of salt and pepper over the top.
I like it oily.
Oh, boy.
Got it?
Oh, beautiful. That's impressive. Okay, now we pop that in the oven for how long?
You want to pop it in for around 25 to 30 minutes at 350.
Okay, 350, 25 to 30 minutes. Whoa.
This look magic part.
That's beautiful.
You want to pull it out slowly.
Oh!
There we go. Wow. Wow.
That is beautiful. How are you going to cut this?
Cut it.
So ideally, you want to let this cool down for about 5 minutes.
Yeah, and then you can cut it into slices.
Well, you, I know that you said that you're both dancers.
We can do it all.
Other things.
We can do it all.
Do you want to put that to the test right now?
With who?
Mary?
We need one.
You swung this on us.
Mary, please.
Let me out!
She can't get on there quick enough.
Maestro, the music.
Right, Debbie, you come here. I'll dance for you.
Wait, you're dancing waltz.
I'll have Debbie.
You too.
Oh, we'll waltz.
Oh,
right.
You're going to waltz.
Whatever you want.
Debbie, you've got to come in as well. I don't want to get my hands on
What do we do?
You've got to follow me. I've got to take the lead.
Oh, my goodness. This isn't how you dance, it is.
Low down. You know it.
That's so funny.
For the full recipe, head to our website and check out Alberti Twins' social media.